Picture this. You are zipping through deep space, but there are no stars or planets or anything around. It is just you and the surrounding dark. Now, here's the thing. How could you tell if you're moving at all? Well, as long as you're not accelerating, you don't feel anything different. Everything's just as normal. And if you do any experiments, you'll find the same results as when you're not moving. Apparently, there's no way you could ever know if you're moving. That is, there exists no such thing as an absolute grid of space against which all things move. Therefore, there's no meaning to constant motion on its own. It's only relative. Or is it? Well, in the later 19th century, James Clerk Maxwell discovered something pretty incredible. He found that light always travels at one constant speed. The speed of light, nothing more and nothing less. Then the obvious question at the time was, speed of light relative to what? Remember, constant motion is relative. So the people proposed that maybe there's some everywhere permeating medium. They called it ether. And light traveled at its constant speed relative to this ether. That's great. This provides a backdrop for measuring all motion, giving them an intrinsic meaning. But this is science, and that means experimentation. So when we tried to measure the impact of this ether on the speed of light, what we found was just astonishing. No matter how fast you're moving, you always measure the same speed of light. No more and no less. Just like all the other laws of physics, the constant speed of light is a law, true for all observers. Sorry, ether. But this is crazy. How could it ever be that you measure the same speed of light as I do, even if you're heading towards the light? You've got to see it slow down, but somehow you don't. How on earth could it be? It is here we must do away with our presumptions about space and time, because things are about to get freaky. Think about it, the only way this could be is that somehow your measurements of distances and durations get a bit squeezed and stretched. Only then could we both agree on the same speed of light. And true it is! Experiments have repeatedly confirmed that for moving things, time passes slowly, and their lengths are all a bit squeezed up. Space and time conspire together to make us all agree on one thing, the speed of light. But doing so, they profoundly change our conceptions about them. And this opens up the whole new world of relativity where awesome things like time travel become a possibility. And it was all but a little wandering off the obvious that revealed this truly marvelous future of our universe. Who knows how many more ideas remain unquestioned that might bring another Einstein with another breakthrough. Think about it.